brings his team to the line with a single running back behind him. Alabama with four down linemen to ball on the right hash. This is Manning. Crowd deafening. Handoff Graham comes to the near side at the corner. 25-30. Outside 35-40. 45-50. 45-40. 35-30. 25-20. 15-10. 5. Yes. He went all the way. Is there a marker in the field? There is no marker on the field. Touchdown, Tennessee!
It's time for the Philip Fulmer Show, the only weekly television program that brings you an inside look at Tennessee football. Hosted by the head football coach at the University of Tennessee, Philip Fulmer. And the voice of the Vols, John Ward. Brought to you by First Tennessee Bank. For all Philip Fulmer Show.
Over a half century ago, somebody dubbed the Alabama-Tennessee game Dixie's Great Football War. There have been many battles since, the latest won by Tennessee at Legion Field. The fans were happy, but even happier, the volunteer players and coaches whose first reaction was to go thank the fans.
Isn't that something? That was a great moment. And our fans were into it. I bet I heard Rocky Top as loud as I've ever heard it in my life. And the kids went right to them, and they responded, and it's just a special, special moment.
It was 41-14 as Tennessee strikes early in this game, and I could say sacks late.
Well, the sacks made a big difference, but getting those 21 points in the first quarter was really important, and obviously Peyton did a great job, and the offensive team did a great job, and the defense getting the ball back for the offense did a super job to set the pace early in the ballgame.
As it was, we're trying to say just a team victory, and don't forget the kicking game.
Absolutely. Larry Binion and Jeff Hall and the coverage teams and the protection teams. Alabama was a team that had blocked, I think, 11 kicks in recent history, the last year and this year, and did a great job. And our team stepped up and played every phase really, really well.
Was there a key moment for you?
There's so many key moments. Obviously, the first play set the tempo. I think the touchdown at the end of the half that Marcus Nash scored. Jay Graham's run we saw at the opening of the show was really, really important. And also, I think the defense, we turned it over one time. I think it was 14 or 21 nothing. Turned it over, and our defense stepped up and stopped them. Those were all big turning points in the football game, I think.
Well, there are a lot of turning points, a lot of big plays, a lot of big moments, especially for Big Orange fans. We'll be seeing it all coming up right here as Tennessee plays Alabama on the Philip Fulmer Show.
Everybody, this is our state governor, Don Sanquist.
Yeah! Coach, thank you very, very much, and thanks to each of you for doing us proud. I don't know of a better day in Tennessee in a long time. I want to say to you how proud we are and what this means to everybody. I want to declare Monday as Tennessee Football Day in Tennessee.
Alabama wins the opening toss, elects to defer, and kicks off. As we're set to pick up the action, the Volunteers playing Alabama at Legion Field. Big play to start before we're rolling the tape. When does a coach or a team call the first play? A week ago?
Really, it's
an hour ago?
It's planned early in the week, and obviously field position has something to do with this. And this is actually just a great play by Peyton and Joey, because there are some answers within this that's not the takeoff route, but Alabama was in kind of a man-under type look, and Joy and Peyton hooked up, great protection, and that's the way to start a football game.
Play number one, game number 78 in this series, and it's Manning on the first play to Joy Kent from Huntsville, Alabama, and it goes 80 yards for the touchdown.
You know, that really had to be a special moment for Joy, you know, catching. He's played well against them ever since he's been here, And as you said, it takes a lot of people to make a play successful, but that one right there, for him to take it the distance, was really special.
There's Hall with the extra point, and 14 seconds into this game, Dixie's Great Football War, Tennessee leads 7-0, and here's Hall kicking off.
You didn't get a particularly good kick here, and the coverage teams did a nice job. I think it's Ronnie Pillow stepping in there and making the play, and Al Wilson some guys. Our kickoff coverage has not been quite what we need to be the last few weeks, but we'll get that right.
Alabama in crimson with Bergdorf at quarterback. He loops the ball out here to the tailback Riddle, who moves forward for a gain of 9 yards, bounced out of bounds by Jenkins, and so it'll be second down and one at the Alabama 40. And then ripping through the right side, Riddle gives the Tide its first down in the game.
A tight wing formation is something we saw plenty of last year, and our guys did a great job this year doing it. I think it's Ron Green from the backside that being there to make a play.
And here will be Bergdorf.
You know, when you put those guys at second long and third and long situations, it allows you to get after the quarterback a little bit. And I thought our kids all night long got after the quarterback.
Third down 10. This pass is complete to the fullback system, but it is short of the first down. And so here comes Stockton in the punt with Tennessee leading still very early in this football game, 7-0. As the punt takes a great skip, goes out of bounds, and Tennessee is backed up to its own 7-yard line.
Pretty good punting exhibition in that ball game on both parts. This was important that we run it and get the ball off our own goal line. Jay hitting the gap play up inside, and that's very good. Very well done.
So it's Tennessee.
This is our transplanted defensive end from a couple of years ago, Chester Ford, who's an outstanding blocker and becoming a better runner all the time.
And it's a first down for Tennessee to the 18-yard line.
Alabama is just an outstanding defensive team. You see, they got a lot of people running the football there, but our kids, for the most part, did an outstanding job of controlling the line of scrimmage.
Statton and Blackford on the stop as Tennessee comes out throwing. This pass is complete to Pfeiffer for 2 yards. Tennessee scoring in its first possession in this game. That's 6 of 7 games this year for the Vols.
You know, that's amazing. You just wish you could think you'd do that all the time. But when you got a guy like Peyton and a group of seniors, Smith, Miller, and Lehman up front, you got a chance.
The pass was complete tonight for the first down, and here's Ronnie Pillow as Townsend breaks on the ball, but Pillow maintains his concentration, and that will be a gain downfield of 36 yards, a second look.
Really close play here. Peyton sticking it in there, and Ronnie, I don't know if we can see it, I think, but Ronnie keeping his concentration, got the ball on the outside arm and protecting it with against the sideline. You can see that's a nice 36-yard gain, I believe.
And it's first and 10 for the Volunteers now at the Alabama 36. Tennessee leads 7-0. Snap throw, this is Nash.
That's just a heck of a play there. If they're blitzing, that's one of the answers that we have. Well picked up front, the same thing.
Manning again. This is Joey Kent. Manning to this point, 6 of 6 in the air for 134 yards and a touchdown. You'll see the time there in the first quarter. There's the first incomplete pass, Maurice Staley.
Well, I tell you, I can't say enough about our young receivers as well. Of course, Joy's not young, but golly, they just stepped up and every week have played better and better in a big ball game like this.
Tennessee went for a touchdown. It was ruled Tennessee was guilty of illegal procedure, and here, coming right back, this is Nash, and it's a TD.
Two special players right there, Marcus Nash and Peyton Manning, and using their abilities, and a heck of a call by David Cutcliffe after being disappointed we didn't get the touchdown from the screen. That was a heck of a play as well.
And so the extra point is up and good, and Tennessee leads by a score of 14-0, 93 yards, 11 plays, and the Vols did in fact overcome a nullified touchdown, came right back to knock home the 14th point.
That's a heck of a kick there by Jeff Hall, and that's where you want him to start, inside the 20-yard line. You see Terry Fair coming up to make the play, and Anthony Hampton, here's the old play. It's been a nuisance to us in the past, and
Steve White
stopped it in a hurry.
He's been watching some tapes, I think. So here it is, 3rd down, 3, Alabama, and there is Leonard Little. There's the fumble. There's the recovery.
Well, that's a good hit and a good play, and Bill Duff and Ron Green around the football. Now, this guy's so quick and got on the quarterback in a hurry. I think actually surprised the heck out of him. It looks like he did hit him right under the chin where you're supposed to, and the ball comes out. Great play.
So Tennessee gets the turnover. 1st down and 10 at the Alabama 24-yard line. Manning, incomplete.
Close. We need to hit him in the chest if we can, and Marcus needs to make that play as well.
2nd down 10, Tennessee 14-0. Deflection, and it is incomplete. Statton, I think, got his hand on the ball. It could have been Hood. Anyway, it's 3rd down and 10 at the 24-yard line. Manning.
This is a little flare pass, flare screen. You see Jay showing his ability and a lot of effort to get up there, I think, the first down.
He made the first down with that little extra effort, as you said, at the end. Let's take another look.
This is a design flare screen, which they had just run on us a little bit earlier, and Bubba Miller out in front trying to get it, and Jay giving a lot of extra effort to get the first one. A little different look. Adam, Jay using those stiff arm, getting upfield. Jay's going to be sore today. He took some hits.
He definitely did. That was Graham.
And he gave some hits, too.
Here's a catapult for 3 yards. And so it's down to the 1 yard line.
That's shades of James Stewart there up and over.
Tremendous dive. And this will be Ford trying to score, but he is knocked and stopped short. So here will be for Tennessee, second down and goal. There was a penalty in there. It's second and goal. Tennessee with the ball. And everybody watches. There is Graham. No. It's Manning.
You like that play, don't you, John?
Of all the plays, I'll remember that one.
That's really well executed. A good call by David Cutcliffe and well executed by Peyton. Alabama's got a very aggressive defense, and we just did a nice job of faking. You see number two going for the tailback there, and then Peyton coming out with the football. Really, nobody knew.
Lehman, this will confirm that fact that Manning has... There you'll see Lehman giving the touchdown with the dive by Graham, but here's Manning scoring the ball as he comes to the left side.
Nobody knew except us and the quarterback. So Cutcliffe and
Sanders, none of the Tennessee players knew exactly what was going to happen.
Exactly.
Yeah. Fortunately, Manning did.
Well, shades of future things to come, right? Because I don't always know what's going to happen next season.
And the extra point is up and good, and Tennessee, still with time left in the first quarter, but we'll close it off right here, leads by a score of 21-0.
If you want to start a first quarter against Alabama, you'd like to be spotted 21 points. They didn't spot us. We earned those points. And our defense is stepping up. There's a great tempo, a lot of enthusiasm in the stadium, and so we can just keep it going that way.
Alabama makes its comeback, and we'll be seeing it here in the second quarter coming up in just a moment.
I don't have any balls. You better get some more.
Wait, I got something to say.
We're gonna have a whole lot of game balls that are gonna come out of this game, but we got one that's important tonight, and it goes to this guy standing right here.
Tennessee leads Alabama by a score of 21-0, and Alabama, adjusting its game plan, changes quarterbacks, and Freddie Kitchens comes in there, and he'll be replacing Bergdorf.
Kitchens is a big, strong guy and has an excellent arm. We knew about him going in, and not quite the nifty runner that Bergdorf was, so we tried to get after him a little bit better. Hard to tackle that guy. But we knew Alabama wasn't going to give up, and they kept coming, and our kids did a good job of continuing to fight.
So we're set to pick up the action right now, as it will be Alabama in control. It will be as they moved after recovering a Tennessee fumble, and this will be Kitchens pulled down by Sanders. There's a fumble, and Tennessee recovers it right back.
That was big. You know, we turned the football over, which is really bad, and then I'm not sure who. Yeah, Sanders, you said, hit him
Sanders
from the backside. And
Burton makes the recovery.
Burton gets it back. That was huge to keep momentum in our favor.
Tennessee leads 21-0, and this will be Graham carrying knockdown. And
we didn't look exactly like ourselves right there either. The pressure bothered us a little bit. We mistimed the snap and then snapped it poorly. Just up there, kind of got people in his face, getting knocked back a little bit, and we have to punt.
And Alabama has adjusted its defense, bringing a lot of people up tight, but this will be the punt by Binion, 43 yards.
Good coverage. You see Leonard Little and Scott Gallion, Eric Lane there, and that was a big punt. Excellent punt by Larry Binion, and he's just doing a better and better job.
But Alabama takes the ball, and they move downfield, and Tennessee leads 21-0, but Kitchens has his teams moving. And it's first and goal at the Tennessee 9. Pass is incomplete, intended for Brown.
George Kidd right there, and I think he got Curtis Brown's attention a little bit there, being in the crossing route and all. And then we get one batted, and they catch that one?
Yes. It was deflected, then Brown stayed alert and made the catch, pinned by Austin. It's third and goal at the Volunteer 6.
Kitchen's a big guy, not a great runner right there. A lot of Volunteers around the ball. Jesse Sanders came in and did a good job for us. Jesse had a banged-up shoulder, and Hampton actually started the ball game, and we don't want to talk about their touchdown right now.
Well, whatever. It all adds up. There's the extra point up and good by Proctor.
They hit us in too deep right there. We just need a little bit of pressure in that one.
70 yards for Alabama, 15 plays, 6 minutes, 43 seconds, and We move along as the Volunteers lead now by a score of 21-7. That was Graham moving for 5 yards, knocked down by Hood and Jackson.
Alabama's, you know, front playing pretty good right there and not getting as much done as we need to. Come right back and they jump Joy Kent, which is a mistake, I can tell you that, and he takes it up on him and Peyton and him connect.
I called it
really
a hitch and go.
Play.
Is that close?
Well, it sort of is because it's supposed to be the hitch, and when the defensive back comes forward, Joy's going to go up on it, and it's an excellent play by both of them.
Kent now has, for the season, 43 catches, 666 yards. There's a strip.
We got it back. Peyton went after that one like he was supposed to go after. We're not supposed to get hit from the backside like that.
Moore got there, and Manning recovered the bobble.
Good play.
Tennessee leading 21-7.
Good hard running by Maurice Daly. He is a tough runner with a football.
13 yards and a first down. It's at the 30-yard line. Manning looking. Nash catching. Nash scoring.
Nice play and run. I didn't know it was that good from my seats. I didn't, where I was standing. That's really a well-thrown ball, and Marcus Nash showing his speed and his ability to get upfield, and then some determination right there at the end to get it in there. Heck of a throw. Wow.
That's Nash.
Good job.
He now has caught in this game 6 receptions, 100 yards. He has 2 touchdowns for the year. He has 4 touchdowns. As this is Manning, and this is Nash, and this is Tennessee.
You know, one thing to have a big receiver like Nash that can run is you see a couple of defensive backs bouncing off of him there. That does help. That's very good.
And it's Hall again for the extra point that is up and perfect. And so the first half has come to a close. Tennessee and Alabama at Legion Field. The Volunteers lead 28-7. More to come right here on the Philip Fulmer Show.
Time now for a big orange slice of life with Bob Kesslick.
Tennessee has always taken pride in its kicking game. The Volunteers have used the kicking game to great advantage, winning many close games through the years. Jeff Hall is the latest Tennessee kicker to shine on the field. The redshirt freshman from Franklin, Tennessee, has already etched his name in the Tennessee lure with his game winner against Georgia.
The Georgia game, that last field goal, you know, I went out and I wasn't thinking about anything. You know, I was like, oh, please God, be with me for this. And, you know, he was. And I didn't think of anything. My mind was completely blank, and I just went out and worried about kicking the ball, and I figured out, you know, that's what I need to do every time. And so that's what I try to work on in practice, just kind of getting completely focused on each kick.
Jeff Hall, though, had to wait his turn at Tennessee. He was redshirted last year and watched John Becksport set all kinds of UT and SEC records. Watching, waiting, and working helped Hall get ready for this season.
Tried to pattern my work ethic and everything after him, and he taught me how to handle game situations and practice and how to work in the weight room and what to concentrate on and what not to give any thought to.
Playing for Tennessee is a dream come true for Jeff Hall. He always wanted to be a Volunteer and knew he was coming to Tennessee very early in the recruiting campaign.
You know, I've always been a Tennessee fan. I always, you know, wanted to come here and kick, and it always been my dream.
Jeff Hall has one of the strongest legs in the SEC. He showed it off against Oklahoma State, pounding home a 53-yard field goal. Long, booming field goals, though, are impressive, but Hall strives for consistency, not necessarily distance.
Mental preparation is a whole lot different than physical, you know, obviously, and I have a little thing I go through each week, you know, before games. I'll think about the game. I'll think about different situations, different kicks that I'll have to do, extra points, field goals, kickoffs. You know, I'll do that, you know, throughout the week, and the night before the game, I'll really get into it and, you know, think about the whole game and different kickoffs, like before the half or starting the game, then field goals before the half and extra points and everything after a big touchdown and everything. That's pretty much how my mental preparation goes.
Tennessee has been fortunate down through the years to have some of the best kickers in college football. Jeff Hall is working hard to boot his way into the Tennessee record book. For the Philip Fulmer Show, I'm Bob Kesslink.
Really proud of Jeff Hall, John. He is a special young man from Winchester, Tennessee, by the way. Who said Franklin?
Kesslink didn't major in geography.
Franklin County, right? But Billy and Billy Wayne and Paula were classmates of mine in high school and just beautiful people, wonderful people. Dick O'Brien and that whole kicking unit does a great job, and we're really proud he's at Tennessee. He's a great Christian young man, does a lot with the FCA, and he's also an outstanding student.
And he is the man who kicked Tennessee to a victory earlier and is one of the leading kickers in the country already this year in field goals and extra points as well. More to come the second half. Tennessee and Alabama in just a moment. Alabama at halftime by a score of 28-7. The Tide will receive the kickoff to begin the second half of the game, and we're ready to begin the action right here. Alabama wearing crimson, Tennessee in the white jerseys as the kick comes downfield, is bobbled, picked up by West, and then West is...
Good play.
Tackled as he returns by Moore.
That was Dustin Moore in there and making the play, and we came out. Well, there was a lot said at halftime that was really important, and our senior stepped up there, and we weren't going to not go out and play well.
Kitchens at quarterback, back to throw the first pass intended for Brown, incomplete now. He is flushed out of the pocket. It's nailed after a two-yard gain by Burton. It will be third down and eight.
Burton and Gay and two seniors that are playing extremely well. I think they picked on Terry a little bit over there last night. It came his way. He was a short side guy a lot, and that allows for you to have throws to your side some. And
Brown
needing some underneath help there. We'll look in film and see what we need to do better there.
This one,
you see how strong
Bad Key
old Kitchen really is. You said he's 240 or something like 230. He's a big guy, I know that.
He came in overweight, they say, as the season began. But Tennessee comes, and here's the sack, and Galyon is the man who's there.
Pressure, John Chavis making a really nice call to bring the extra linebacker and one more than they've got blockers for, and that's a heck of a job. Puts our coverage in man-to-man, but we needed that.
Second down, 21. Tennessee leading 28-7. Alabama with Kitchen looking, picking on Fair, and Fair reacts.
Fair responds. That's what he's supposed to do. Good job by him. And, well, Kevin Ramsey's done a good job with our secondary. You see him sinking back in two deep coverage and letting them have the short route, but not going to let them have the long route. That's well done after sack.
Terry Fair with the interception, his first of the year. Tennessee has 9 interceptions when this game is over. And the Volunteers then unable to move with the ball, a punt downfield. Brilliant punt by Binion, goes out of bounds at the 3-yard line. But as we say, Coach Fulmer, it sets up Alabama for a drive.
90-something yards, you certainly don't want that. We had a chance right there to start the drive without anything. Happen. See Scott Gallion in there again.
That pass intended for Malone is incomplete. It's at the Tennessee 28, third down and 8.
This is the darnest thing. You know, that's our ball when we tip it up like that, and they come down with it.
Excellent play by Chad Key.
17 plays, is that right?
That's right.
That's not good.
That long pass is intended for Brown. So here's the new tailback, number 21, Madden, who has not played, but now he has, and now this will be Madden breaking a tackle, and he goes in for the touchdown, Alabama.
A lot of missed tackles in this drive, and that's really the only bad drive that I think that we had, the only bad series we had defensively. Defense did a great job of holding them to right at 300 yards of total offense, and basically, what was it, 70 yards rushing, something like that for the game?
In that range, as that was a 97-yard drive, so it will be Tennessee returning the kickoff, and the lead has been shaved, and Alabama with its comeback, trailing 28-14. Who knows what will happen? Here's what happened.
Wasn't going to be any comeback. Che Graham just did a great job of outrunning the defense, well blocked up front, using his track speed, and Bubba Miller makes probably the best tackle of the day right here, I think, at the end, in the end zone. I guess they're going to see it, but...
There was track speed, yeah, because some of the Alabama players had a decent angle. But here's Jay Graham to the outside. He will, on this run, go over 100 yards in this game, his longest run from scrimmage on the season. And this means that in 6 of 7 games, the Concord, North Carolina tailback has gained over 100 yards. And what a run by Jay Graham.
What a run at a very, very important time. And I'm proud of for Jay. We've been looking for Jay to pop one. His longest before that had been 27 yards and got a lot of ability.
So Tennessee answers the Alabama touchdown. Graham had something to do with the answer, and the kickoff comes downfield. Hall with the extra point is 31 of 32 on the year, and the return by West.
Eric Lane making the tackle. West is a dangerous guy, really fast. Now we can really pin our ears back and come after him. That's Bill Duff, and then Leonard Little finishing it off.
Little with 6 sacks on the year. Tennessee has 24 all told. This is Kitchens.
That's a heck of a job. Our tackles have been trying to make more plays in the pass rush, and Coach Dan Brooks has done a good job with them, and Steve Caldwell with the defensive ends.
That's fair defending against Brown, so it will be for Alabama at its 15, third down and 17 yards to go.
Looks like we had that one, John, didn't it?
Well, no comment.
This is what you like to see a quarterback doing, getting up off their quarterback, that is, getting up off the ground, even if he gets the ball off. We hit Kitchens a lot of times. Had a chance here. Good job by Sean taking it up inside, and I'll do a little bit different, a couple of different things in the kicking game that our kids did real well, and that helped us in the ball game.
So the Volunteers build their lead. It's now 35-14 on the strength of the run by Jay Graham, and there's action to come here in the final moments of this football game, and we'll be showing you the highlights in just a moment.
Seniors, absolutely proud of you. I'm not going to say any speeches, guys. This is a great day in Tennessee football history. We get ready to start our streak of our own, by guys.
Obviously a big win for Tennessee, but the 41 points ties the highest mark Tennessee's ever had against Alabama. Tennessee scored 41 in the 1969 by identical score of tonight's victory, and then again in 1983.
As Tennessee wins the football game, but there's still action to come, more scoring coming up as the Volunteers now lead with a couple plays left in the third quarter, and we're going to pick up the action right there. Tennessee does lead by a score of 35-14. Sean Summers has returned the punt, and we pick it up with Manning at quarterback.
This is Manning passing.
This is Nash. No, he's going to throw. Nash downfield, complete to Kyler.
Nice heck of a catch by Greg Kyler. You can see Peyton and Marcus making sure that it's a lateral, and I'm not sure exactly about the technique here of Marcus Nash, but what a catch by Greg Kyler going up, turning his body all the way around. And again, man-to-man coverage gives you some one-on-one opportunities, and is a good call by David Cutcliffe and well executed by offense.
Nash this year in the air, 1 of 1 for 28 yards. Kyler, his 8th catch, 138, pass across the middle, it's complete.
Not only can he throw, he can catch.
13 yards, he had 6 catches, 100 yards, all told on the year, 393 yards receiving for Nash and 4 touchdowns. Now, it is into the fourth quarter.
You know, a receiver in our offense, John, really has a chance to be special. And of course, recruiting is always important, but you're going to get coached hard here, too, and to be a good receiver.
That's Graham at the left side. He carried the ball 17 times for 114 yards and a touchdown in this game. Staley dumped by Bryant, and so Tennessee has it third down and goal at the 8-yard line.
You know, it gets close down here, and there's not a lot of room to operate your passing game, and sometimes it's just very, very difficult. Peyton throwing that ball away wisely, and did we take the field goal here?
Yep. Why not?
Yep.
It's
Why
Jeff
not?
Hall for the field goal that is up, and it is good from 25 yards away, so he's now 11-14 on the year, and Tennessee leads Alabama by a score of 38-14. As the Volunteers with Hall again kicking.
You see Jeff kicking it just about 2 or 3 yards into the end zone, and that's where you want to make them start from, because they have very little chance if the ball's got some height on it. Good coverage.
Alabama with the ball out of the shotgun. Kitchens at quarterback throwing. Tipped. It is intercepted, Tennessee.
Like that. Now just get up the field and get that ball secured right there. That's Deron Jenkins, and we're really proud of Deron. The leadership, he's got, three interceptions for this
four
year?
All told on the year, among the leaders in the conference right now.
Really doing well, but on the practice field, he's setting a great example, and I'm very, very proud of him.
The pass, Manning, Kent, 8 yards. Kent, 5 receptions, 117 yards in the game.
George, one of the leading receivers in the conference now, and certainly steps up in the big games. There's Marcus Nash again. I was concerned. I hurt his ankle right there from the other sideline.
It was Kent for 8, Nash now for 9, and this will be Graham at the left side, knocked down by Jackson. Tennessee has the ball at the Alabama 10-yard line, 2nd down and 9 to go for the first down, 10 to go for a touchdown. There's the quickness of Alabama defensively.
You can see the safety showing up, and there's not anybody accounting for him in the running game. We just don't have all that many blockers, And this series just wasn't, the last two really wasn't that good. We'll work to get better, and we weren't going to just throw it all over the place either.
Everybody coming. Manning is sacked, only 2 sacks in the game.
Good job.
Five on the year, and here is Hall again.
It's amazing how consistent he's been. 12 of 15 for the year, and he kicked his extra points well, and he can come right back and kick this kind of kickoff. That's what you're looking for.
Jeff Hall and Larry Binion, a part of the Tennessee victory, as this is Alabama, and here's that
Good
Tennessee
pressure.
Defense. The pressure comes.
Golly, Shane went through about three of them there. That's little Shane.
His
Shane
third
Burton.
Sack of the year.
The senior. And this will be Kitchens.
Let's see Jeff Coleman and Anthony Hampton. Anthony's a linebacker, a big guy that can run, and we play him at defensive end to rush the passer some. Heck of a job.
The sack by Anthony Hampton.
Anthony's got
some of the fans have left, but none of those in orange.
None
this will be orange. Kitchens intercepted.
Heck, good. Good job. We went down to one knee there, and we just need to give the ball back to, and get on there, back to our sideline there, Raymond. But good interception by Ray Austin.
Tennessee leading 41-14. That's the final score. That's the head coach. They're the seniors.
I didn't know they had that. I sort of saw them coming that time.
Well, everybody
get,
in the
let
stands.
Me get the names of those guys that did that. Run that back, Barry.
No replays allowed. As the coach of the Volunteers, Philip Fulmer, sees his team as the seconds are ticking away, as you see in the clock. This will be Jeremy Bates, who, like Jermaine Copeland, got into the game. A lot of Volunteers are part of this victory. 41-14, the Volunteers winning over Alabama. So Tennessee now, and there you'll see the first reaction of the Tennessee players racing to the opposite side to say thank you to the fans.
That was really, really special, and we zipped that hat up into the stands, and it was just a fun, fun evening. And I should really compliment John Chavis and David Cutcliffe and the defense and offensive staff. They did a great job in preparation. I don't believe they went home before 12:30 during the course of the week to get ready for this one.
Well, maybe they went home later than that after the win.
Well, probably they
the
hadn't been home
back,
yet.
The team did not get back until about 2 o'clock.
Tennessee wins over Alabama by a score of 41-14. More to come in the locker room in just a moment.
I'm Condridge Holloway outside of the victorious locker room of the Tennessee Volunteers with Peyton Manning. And Peyton, you know, today looked to me just like a replay of last week. I mean, good organization. You made the plays, you made the calls, and executed well.
It all comes back to preparation, and we had a good week of practice. Everybody was focused coming into the game, and kind of after, you know, that's why I'm glad you have pregame warm-ups. All that extra emotion kind of gets out of the way. You get focused, and just came out and executed well tonight, and what a huge victory.
Alabama streak broke. I know a lot will be talked about there, but basically what you did today was just exploit their weaknesses and showed everybody in the nation that, hey, if you spread them out, you can beat this team.
We gave them a lot of different looks, and like I said, our receivers were one of the strengths of our game. They ran great routes, but I mean, what great protection we had, and Jay popping that long run, that was huge. As a matter of us, came out, started hot early on, and answered when Alabama had a big play. So this is a good overall team effort.
First play of the game, let's go over that play. Big play with Joey Kitt.
Okay, Joey usually tells us sometimes during the game, hey, we got to hook up, let's hook up, you know, let's make a play. This time he told me before the game, and I'm glad he did, because we didn't waste much time early on. Just in case, kind of read that inside nickelback, and he buzzed out the pillow in the flat, and Kent went wide open right down the seam, and I hit him quick, and what a great run after that.
Well, Jay, if anybody ever had any questions about your speed, it was answered tonight. Tell us about your run.
I just tried to get the ball. Robert Poole made a great, great block. And I just tried to get the ball and just head upfield as fast as I can. I was like, well, I gained 10 yards, and I just kept on running. I was like, oh, it's open. It's still open. I just kept on. I saw everybody doing like this on the sideline. I was like, okay. So it was great.
It looked like the defensive game plan was put pressure on the quarterback, which is what you did all day.
Yeah, we felt that with our speed and strength up front, the guys up front, we could put a lot of pressure on the quarterback. And we ran some stunts with the linebackers running in, and we got some sacks that way too. And, you know, I just give a lot of credit to Coach Chavis, putting us in the right place at the right time to make big plays. And, you know, he did a great job with game calling. And, you know, just a lot of credit to the entire defense for coming through with a big game tonight and playing like a Tennessee team capable of playing. And, you know, there's no better feeling this right now.
And we'll be right back with more of the Philip Fulmer Show after this.
This week, our Magnavox Smart Player of the Game is Peyton Manning. Magnavox is making a $500 donation to the Volunteer Athletic Scholarship Fund on behalf of Peyton Manning, number 16.
Certainly not a bad choice, I say that. There's a lot of people that play well in a football game. The quarterback gets a lot of criticism when the team doesn't do well, and a lot of credit, and duly so, when they do. And Peyton has a lot of things. A lot of things have been said about him, but he is a competitive guy, I tell you.
And here's a play I'll never forget.
I'm going to get you a copy of that, and it'll be in
Please.
The mail to you Monday.
Peyton Manning, the player of the week, and last week's SEC player of the week, and he's our Magnavox player this week.
I'd say he has a chance again to be the conference player. He's doing really well, and we want him to come. South Carolina's next.
More to come in just a moment. Alabama 41-14. Your jacket looks nice.
Thank you. I am proud of my jacket. The governor declared tomorrow as the Tennessee football day, and I started today.
And most fans say Tennessee football day is 365 days a year. Open date. You're going to take a day off?
Going to take a day off. Of course, staff is recruiting. We're going to rest and recuperate as a football team, get ourselves ready for South Carolina.
Tennessee has an open date coming up. The Volunteers return home to play South Carolina. And we'll have the broadcast, of course, on the Vol Radio Network. Following that, Southern Mississippi. Tennessee now 6-1 overall, 4-1 in Southeastern Conference play, with a victory 41-14 over Alabama. See you in 2 weeks.
In front of the Volunteer fans at the north end, northeast corner of the field, as the Volunteers have come to Birmingham, and Tennessee will go home with a 41-14 victory.
Yeah.